All right, so before we actually get into functional programming or object-oriented programming for that matter with Python, we need to discuss some basic types and then variables and then some other stuff. So in this video, we're going to be covering numbers. So what is a number? Well, I'm sure you guys know what a number is. I'm sure we've all been through grade primary and ones, so we're all familiar with that. Now, there's two different types of numbers. One's called an integer and then a floating point. The floating point is basically any number that has a decimal included in it. So let's go ahead and write out some numbers on the screen. Now I'm going to be using the Python console down here for this video, so watch down there. That's where stuff's going to happen. So for an instance of a number, we can just write a number. It's going to appear in the console or the IDE or whatever, has syntax highlighting that you're using. It's going to show as blue, or it should. Actually, that really depends on your color scheme that you've got going on. It's going to show a specific color. Now, we can just use numbers in Python just by writing the numbers. And if we hit enter, it's going to print out 5. Now, with numbers, we can perform mathematical operations on these numbers, as you saw in some of the previous videos that we've done so far. So I could write 5 plus 6, and we're going to get a response of the sum of 5 plus 6. Now, what would happen if I wrapped these numbers in quotations? So let's go ahead and write 5 plus 6. If you think that this will produce 11, you're wrong. It's going to produce 56. And you might be thinking, hold up, 5 plus 6 does not equal 56. You're absolutely right. Not in math, however. When you're concatenating strings, it does. So basically, when you wrap something in quotations in Python, Python is going to treat it as a string, not a number. So if you're trying to perform mathematical operations, just remember, don't wrap your numbers in quotations. Now, additionally, we can use floating points to perform math operations. And you can see it returns a floating point. Now, if we ran 5 plus 5.5, it's going to still return a floating point. However, the last, it's 11.0, because we've passed it, decimal floating point numbers, and so it's going to return with one because that's just how it works. Now we're going to talk about how to convert different types, I guess. These are called types. A number is a type, a string is a type, and right here we've shown both numbers and strings, and we're going to cover strings in the next video. But for right now, let's say, well, I have some numbers, but they're wrapped in quotations, and I still want to perform mathematical operations on them. How can I do that? So basically, in Python, there's a built-in function called int, which will convert a string to a number if that string contains only numbers. So let's look at a correct usage of int and then an incorrect usage and see the output for both. So let's say I have the number 5 wrapped in quotations. What I'm going to do is wrap that in the int function. And this is also how you write a call to a function in Python. And then I'm going to perform a mathematical operation on it with another number wrapped in quotations. Now, this is not going to produce 57. In fact, it's going to convert both of those into integers and then perform the math operations on them. So that's how to add up different numbers that are contained within quotations. Let's have a look at trying to convert text to an integer. So let's write int, and let's write hello, let's hit enter. As you can guess, it's printing out an error because there's an invalid literal for int with base 10. basically, what that means is we've passed it something that is not an integer. So think of this function basically as it takes whatever you put into the function, it removes the quotations, and then returns that. Same if I just type this, Python's going to freak out because it doesn't know what hello is, because this is going to be interpreted not as a string, but it's going to be interpreted as computer code. And we're going to get more into strings in the next video.